VTV, great to have you with us for a Tuesday night. Start of a new week. It was great to have last night off, but of course we are headed towards round 12, the back third of the season, as everybody is scrambling for a chance to make the finals in 2018. Now tonight we're heading out on the road, heading out to the Hume City Broncos and catching up with a player who has starred in this competition for a number of years now. He's with the Broncos, of course, played some time at Bulleen Boomers as well. Came out here and played NBL back in the day. Mike Rose, he is a sharp shooter. He's very, very good with the ball in his hands, and he's good in front of the camera as well. Sit back and enjoy. Here's Mike Rose from the Hume City Broncos.
I got a workout with the Washington Wizards and Milwaukee Bucks, and I started getting like a mock draft. It was on the internet, and it had my name like 24th. So it was like, oh, so I was surprised, and then you hear certain talks. And then, so it got to the point where I was excited, nervous, and just was unsure.
Okay, it's rap pack to my pulse flat. We keep it real, no false rap. I got four cars and they all black. Got four bras and they all that. We call that ballin'. Doing this is my calling. Flow is so appalling. My phone off and she calling. I'm like,
For me, it was like my whole family played basketball as well, like a few others. But my aunts, uncles, they all had the NBA dream, so. As a kid, for me, it was seeing them play every day. It was one of those things where I was just attached to the game. And street ball was pretty big, so that started my whole love for the game. In Chicago, the whole Chicago area, so my dad was like on the west side of Chicago. So growing up with him, you know, everybody's outside playing. I didn't really start the indoor street, like playing basketball until like my mid days of, you know, being a child, but yeah, everything was outdoors. You know, for me, it's aggressive. So you kind of learn how to play through certain contacts of the game and teaches you a different mentality, I think, as far as, you know, a lot of kids, I feel like, especially myself at that time, before the street ball, I was like real shy. So I would shy away from certain things, but the street ball game, it makes you have to come out of that shell, or you just sit down and watch, you know. So I think that taught me a little bit more of that aggressive nature. I was in Missouri for most of my childhood years after leaving Chicago, and then came back to the Chicago area, a place called Naperville, and I went to my junior senior year there. And where I was in Missouri, it was like a very small town, so I knew if I wanted a scholarship or to be seen, I had to, you know, go back into Chicago area. And eventually I played AAU basketball, which is big. And that summer after my junior year, I was able to get discovered and I made a name for myself. And then my senior year, did well enough to get a scholarship as well. And just took off from there. Well, it was an area like after my senior year, I was supposed to be like drafted now. This was the talks, but that didn't happen. So I ended up taking it and I went to Turkey. That was my first year, it was my rookie year, and I was there for 4 months. I got cut there. And for me, just I guess that shy era of my life, you know, kind of took over and I kind of went in a shell, confidence-wise. But my agent found here, and that's how I became, you know, ball player here in Australia. Someone, I believe, got hurt during that season. This is when Ansi and all those guys were playing. And so it allowed, you know, an open spot. And my agent, I guess, contacted, I'm not sure if it was Seamus or, you know, Al, but somehow it puzzled together and I was able to come from that. I'm not sure, like, who else was involved, but for me, it was just an opportunity that I was glad to take. The first game we had here, I think it was, I'm not sure who we played, but you know, I finally got my chance to get in, and I was here for the first three games we had when I was here. I didn't play because I was still trying to learn the shuffle, which is, man, that's a tough offense. But yeah, so I finally get my chance, and the first time, like, I got in, first shot I had a three ball in the corner, and I hit, and the crowd just went crazy. So from there, it was like kind of, you know, built my confidence just off of that. I think it was, I was here for five months, I want to say, 4 to 5 months. Once the season ended, there was we were trying to come back, and it was an opportunity, it was a possibility, but ended up going to New Zealand after that. Was in New Zealand for half of their season, and I came back this way to try to come and play again. And I went to a showcase in Adelaide just to try to get my name back in there with some other teams, and didn't end up happening right then. So I went back to Chicago and tried to find other teams, and then from there I went to Germany and Belgium, and yeah, my career just kept going from there. Environment-wise, just people, where I was, it wasn't a lot of sun, so I felt like that might have had something to do with, some of the personalities. Everyone was kind of down at times, but they were still nice, like very nice people. And here, it's basketball-wise a lot faster, kind of like the States to me. But then, yeah, very friendly people was here. Like, as soon as I got here as well, like so many others, it's just welcoming. Yusuf Kafo, one of my real good friends, he was playing for Berlin at the time. And that was actually the coach I'm playing for now. And I think Yusuf wanted me to come back after playing with him with the Tigers, so we stayed in contact. And he told the coach about me, and he told me to come and offer me, a contract. And from there, we did well. That was nice. He was young, very young at that time. So he kind of stayed in his lane, so to speak. But he could have, just to watch him dominate at that age. I'm like, I'm sitting there 20-something years old and he's 16. But he was a beast at that age still. At that time, it was kind of like I knew he was going to be good. But it's just the question of, like, how good is this guy going to be? And to see him take off how he is now, happy for him, man. Just wish him all the best. For me, Big V, I've seen it grow since I've been here. The competition has gotten better and better. And it's one of those things, like, I know it's not the NBL, but you got a lot of guys here that can play. So you don't feel like just because I'm not in the NBL, this isn't worth it. It's still a great place to play, and I'll recommend it to anybody. So for them to keep giving me the opportunity to play here, this is home for me as far as ball. It's nice to see it, evolving, actually. And I think Melbourne needs it, like Australia. And there's a lot of guys here that can play. So just to have that street ball mentality and have it in a different light, it's good to see. Some of the guys that I've known that play around here, for them, they tried it out, the street ball tournament, and they love it. Not to say that was the first time playing street ball, but you got to get a feel of like how it is in the States. And I think they did a great job with it, man. So it's good to see that growth. It's hard to say, anything can happen. As long as I can stay healthy and everything, man, that's my biggest thing. But if I can keep playing wherever it takes me, I'm all for it.
Well, great to catch up with Mike Rose. He is a star player in the state championship men's competition with the Broncos and has been for a number of years. Now, tomorrow night, back at the desk, a little bit of fun. We are talking the five most versatile players in the Big V, male and female, so far in season 2018. Some interesting lists coming your way tomorrow night on Big V TV, 5:30 p.m. We'll see you then.